you know, there is something to be said. I mean, what you get from school that's more important, in my opinion, for animation than the degree, because you don't necessarily need a degree, but is you have your peers, which end up being your first network. Like Darren was saying, she already had friends who were working. So that's really huge, is to go to school, any school studying animation, you'll have friends who graduate before you who are working. The other thing is, schools can put a fire under your butt to make your film. You know, a lot of people, they really want it, but they don't, you know, it's, there's something to be said about that pressure of, I have to finish my film because everyone's going to finish their film. And there's going to be this show at the end of the year, whether it's the CalArts producer show or the SVA, you know, animation night, or, you know, whatever show it is, like there is something to be said for the pressure and making yourself finish a film. Like I'm, as a recruiter and also working in development with our development team, I am always looking at Twitter and Vimeo and trying to find, you know, Instagram all over the place, just trying to find the next new voice. So, so if you're someone who is really self-motivated and self-propelled, then, and you can just make a film without someone telling you to make a film, then just make a film. Sometimes people need the structure of school and deadlines, so there's no shame in that either.
So the first question we have, we kind of just answered, but Gustavo Franco asks, I see that it's said that college doesn't completely matter in animation. What are the benefits you find about going to college? So what, you know, what we've said, like networking with your peers and, you know, having deadlines for yourself.
I mean, obviously, you know, your teachers, there's a reason they're instructors. Like my mentors at CalArts meant so much to me, and having mentors or teachers who have worked in animation. I taught for 3 years, I taught at CCS in Detroit, and the teachers there were just as great and knowledgeable as the teachers at CalArts. Like they had all worked in animation. So, I mean, I don't want to say you have to go to school, but I also don't want to poo-poo school, because it is an amazing experience to have someone who's done this before you and, you know, might expose you to films you didn't know. Like, I mean, we all have Vimeo and YouTube and all these things, but if you don't know where to look for, you know, UPA films of the 1950s or, you know, whatever, it's like, you might still get a more, I would think that you'd have a more well-rounded education if you do go to school, but I heart school. So, but if, you know, if I needed the structure and the discipline of school to make me get stuff done, and some people don't.
And also just experience of it. I mean, I will say, as like a nerdy artist kid, I never felt more at home than at CalArts. I just felt like it was like, okay, I found my people, like this is awesome. And I really, really, really enjoyed the 4 years there. And I think though, you know, I mean, of course, a place like that is very expensive. I think something though that a lot of people maybe don't realize though is that you can find scholarships oftentimes. I actually got some really good scholarships from CalArts. I didn't even have to like pay for my last year at all. I think I got like full scholarship, and I think I got a half scholarship on the third year. Did have to take out some loans, you know, all that stuff. But if you're really, really trying to work in this industry, you can pay off those loans though. Like it's doable, you know. So I don't know. I mean, I would say that it's worth doing if it's something you want to pursue.
There's some schools, some non-private art schools, like Cal State Fullerton, San Jose State, UCLA, Cal State Long Beach, and Northridge, like just in this not too far area. Those are, you know, they're state colleges. Well, UCLA is, you know, a UC, but they're a lot less expensive than a private art college. And you can get, I've hired from all of those just as much as CalArts. Art Center too. I mean, as far as like, if you want to go the private school route, Art Center is great for their design programs.
I think another good example of another benefit of school is also learning to work with others, because sometimes you'll have a thesis film that's like a group project, you know? And I think it's really vital to learn how to work with other people on the same project. you'll also gain that experience, obviously, once you're in the industry working on a project. But yeah.
But yeah, it does help. I will say too, like something that I always lent to CalArts as far as like me being a showrunner is making your own film every single year there was such a great experience for like a couple of reasons. So one of them is like, if it's like, hey, make your own film, it's like, oh my God, how do I do that? You know, I've never made a film before. But you know, your classes are kind of teaching you how to do it. It's like, okay, I need to, and you're doing everything yourself. I need to do layout for this film. I need to do storyboards for my film. I need to do character designs for my film. I need to paint backgrounds for my film. I need to animate it. I need to edit the animation. Is my film going to have talking? Well, maybe I'll go to the acting department and see if I can get a couple actor friends to come over and do voices. Is my film going to have music? Well, maybe I'll go over to the music school. And I got to kind of curate the film and work with different departments at the school in a small way. And really, that's kind of a version of making the show, right?
Yeah.
So that was really, really valuable experience.